Blue and Watch.
Blue and Watch. He's been switching from Blue and Red today.
All right, looks like they want to get straight into it. I'm assuming doing his rock, paper, scissors strategy at the whole way is still rock and still win anyways.
It's like they're starting
somewhere.
Yeah, which is a little
high. Big Blue.
There we go.
Big Blue.
Big Blue! I don't think they'll do it. Fuck you, floats. I don't know.
Like my flow. Alright. So. Okay, come on, Ogus. There we go. Anyways, getting into this match. Magnum, he's been going to Falco pretty much all day to get to it, I think. And Blake, yeah, as you said earlier, he's kind of switching back and forth between Red and Blue and Watch, trying to be 3D.
Right.
And Watch actually is 3D in this game. For, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's 3D model.
It's so crazy, though.
Yeah, I do feel like Game & Watch, his main things in this magic are the disjointed range, and he can get some pretty crazy stuff off of, like, down tilt, for example, against fastballers like Falco. Yeah, that's true. I've learned that today. Yeah, it's so powerful, and it has a massive hitbox, too. Yeah, you know. I wonder if Bucket, I know that in some of the later games, if he absorbs something, he gets a ton of an extra MVI. So I wonder if it's that. Or I should know that much about Game & Watch, in Melee at least, outside of getting an air. I know that pretty well.
I brought it back there. Not too much of a difference this time.
Game & Watch, he has kind of an interesting, like, double use to his crouch cancel in low percent. Because when he crouches, he's short enough that a lot of moves just go straight over him. And then, even if he gets hit, he's just, oh, well, I'm holding that.
Exactly. He was, manual cover.
Yeah. Blake's really good about light shielding things. The shield takes extra damage, but only Game & Watch is mainly goblins. Anyways, one of Game & Watch's problems in this game is that in his shield, it doesn't actually cover his hands or his feet, just because of the way he stands for it. Alright, at least that's what I've heard, and I can definitely see the logic behind it, but light shielding makes the shield bigger, so that makes that a much smaller issue.
Right.
Just pay attention to his stance when he shields something.
Oh, yeah.
It's so easy to shield. That was. However, he is Game & Watch, so he's going to make it back. I'm not sure if Blake is slightly late on these or if Magnus.
Blake's just shielding him.
Yeah. There we go. And that just sends him so far, and it's like.
It does a lot of fight shield over a lot of things.
Oh, yeah.
So even if we were to do a down air or a forward air, back air, whatever, that parachute does have a lot of priority over a lot of moves.
Yeah, and it lingers long enough to beat air dodges, and spot dodges, and rolls.
So it's like second kick side, like Fox Combo out. Just power through.
Oh wow, okay. Hits him too low for Game & Watch's up B to recover, and for that, Magnum will take Game 1. Whoops, that double click. There we go.
I wonder if Blake will switch. Blake has pretty good output too, so.
And he does.
I don't know.
It could be interesting to see if Blake had power bracket. He wasn't trying to stay like, Game & Watch for CJ.
Right, I've switched once or twice, but.
Yeah, I've almost. I think I've seen it in one match. Killer combo? What's up? Wow, okay. Blake just getting comboed back and forth 80% off stage, and then roll get up.
Will stock 2017.
Yeah. That's gonna be pretty rough to come back from, but
Blake can do it.
That he can. manages to up the, when he realized that the Nair was coming, he's like, I need to get out of the way for this. Oh!
He didn't run quick enough. There we go, though. 3%, that ain't bad. Pretty much what we need now.
Definitely. Quite the comeback after that first hog, too. Right. I wonder if Game & Watch is up tilt, beats up those down air. Like, I wonder if it's actually disjointed enough for that. I would assume that his up smash is, because if it's anything like the other games, his head's invincible. Making it a really good anti. Forward smash doesn't connect it, gets flared.
So it's just a scrub that. Yeah. I don't think Plague was too happy about this one.
Went for the roll read. Plague is just like, nah, not doing that.
Not happy.
Gonna hate you. Ooh, back air, we'll take it though. Game & Watch is a really light character as well. I would assume the second lightest in the game after Jiggs.
Right. I thought it was even lighter than Jiggs.
I don't know, it certainly seems like it when I'm fighting people. I know that at least in later games, it's Jiggs, Game & Watch, and everyone else.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
A neutral player, though. Again.
Back throw? Yeah. Oh, that looks like quite a ways off.
Oh, they switched places again.
Okay, I'm gonna step off to get PM top 8 going. This is Jackson, signing off the bird.
Back to one-stop game. Wonder, we're gonna get him out. Game Watch has a top hit. Those lasers, four there. Likes the baby tap. Back air. I wonder what Game Watch is aiming for.
Thank you. itself like.
I'm so strong, Fox. I think I made that joke last time.
Thank you.